Welcome back to our Saber virtual demos. In this series, we're going to be looking at new features in 2021. And one of the coolest features that I have found is the ability to add non-inventory items to planning and requisition worksheet. So let's jump in and take a look. So here we are inside of Business Central. And the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to navigate to my item list so we can take a look at the item card. So here's my traditional list of my items. I can already see here that it's non-inventory, but I'm going to drill in. So what you may notice in version 19, which I really like, is when you have type set to non-inventory, some of your traditional fast tabs are hidden so it cleans up the page. So if I change my type to inventory, you'll see down below that my traditional planning, item tracking, and warehouse, they're not lost. They're just not usable or needed in the case of a non-inventory item. So Microsoft has auto-hidden those fields that don't serve a purpose, which is really helpful for people when they're first learning a software to be focused on the fields they need. So as I've said, this is a non-inventory item. So the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to navigate to my requisition and planning worksheets. So first we'll go to the requisition worksheet. So my type is still going to be set to item. And when I drop down the list, you'll notice that I can see that non-inventory item in my system. So I'm going to go ahead and select that. And then I can flow through and manually enter in the lines based on what I need. And then I can continue to go. I can continue to add inventory and non-inventory items. And then whoever's going to be doing the purchasing in this scenario can go ahead and they can just do their traditional carryout action message. So in this next example, I'm going to navigate to my planning worksheet. And as most of you know, the planning worksheet looks at not only purchased items, but produced items and assembled items as well. So again, I can go ahead, I can drill into my number field, and I can see my non-inventory item. Here I can indicate the quantity that I need. I can see that it's purchased. If I have the columns chosen, I'd be able to see the vendor number. I could update the vendor number if I want to. But then again, once my line information is entered, whomever needs to do so can go ahead and carry out action messages to create that purchase order. Visit our website or click on the link in the description to check out the blog on this and other impressive new features that enhance manufacturing capabilities inside of Business Central.
Thank you for watching our videos. Please follow our channel by clicking here to stay up to date with the latest content or click here for more great videos. Don't forget to visit our website at saberlimited.com. We look forward to seeing you next time.